Good morning, sir, and welcome to another day of the Video Diary. How's it going? Today has been a sleepy day. It's been a day of rest and reconfiguration, trying to figure out what the hell I need to do and things and when and how to do it and thingamajigs. Shortly after I left you, I came back to the flat. I had had a little bit of things to eat, like a couple of biscuits and stuff, and then had a quick hour nap before going to lecture. Oh God, I was tired. It was so strenuous last night. It was proper, like, deep thinking stuff. It wasn't just like just trying to figure out how to do things. It was like actually, it was so strenuous. I'd never thought so hard on an all-nighter. That was the most tiring all-nighter I've ever done. And I think it was a combination of not having food or water at all for the entirety of it, and even just the amount of thought I had to go into it. I've never programmed something that's taken so much friggin' effort. So I went to the maths lecture. Me and Harry, I'd already had a nap. Harry hadn't had a nap. He's just snoozing in friggin' lecture. I was like, come on, Harry, stay with me. Texting him on Facebook. So I'd, stay with me, Harry. And then and then at the end of it, it was a bit of a non-lecture, really. We just did examples of the things that we've already been taught how to do, which is jolly good fun. So I came back here and then slept again. Went back to sleep. I had 3.5 hours of sleep, I think. My alarm was set for 4, and I got to bed about 1-ish. But it was about 4:30 that I woke up. My alarm was still going off. Bit of a heavy sleeper, lol. And it's like right there as well, look. It's there, I'm there, you've got a low battery. It's not like I've got a lot to tell you, so, Else though, I've been chilling here. I haven't really had much time, to be honest with you, for the entirety of the day. I cooked myself a curry, which was pretty nice, even though I forgot chilies, which is downright annoying. But I cooked a chili and then I freezed half of it, so I've got that ready for a day that I've got to go to work or need something easy to cook. Which is always good. It's always a good thing to have, I think. And then we have done nothing, really. Came in here, chilled out, played a bit of Steam, played a bit of Orcs Must Die. Haven't really recorded anything. Just trying to redo one level. It's really annoying. I can't get 5 scores on it. It's really annoying. And that is it, really. It's just been planning and preparing for All-Nighter 2.0 of this week. I've been helping some other people who've been trying to program it as well, and I've been thinking about how the hell I can implement what I need to implement, which is going to be the fun part. I have an idea how I'm going to do it. Not sure how possible it is though. It's definitely going to be an all-nighter. Just trying to get it in our heads. What we're doing is we're creating a copy of what we've already done. So everything that we've got at the moment isn't being touched. We can hand this in and we can pass with it, which is important. It's a very important thing. I don't want to fudge with it so much that I then suddenly can't pass with whatever I have to hand in. So I'm making a copy, adding multiplayer, adding threading, and it's going to be frigging amazeballs. And it is literally the epitome of trial and error. Also, that freaking poster doesn't want to stay up anymore, hence why that one's there still. That's the only one there. Depresses me. And that's about it, really. It's just been recovering and planning and things, and now I'm going to go to bed. I'm going to watch Sherlock in bed, I think, or I'll catch up on YouTube videos and then watch Sherlock and something and then go to sleep. Same again tomorrow. Got to be up early in the morning, though, tomorrow. Got to start at 9 o'clock, so it's going to be a bit more strenuous, this all-nighter. I'm not sure where it is I'm going to do it, either, because I could do it here. I could do it in East Building with a couple of peeps. Depends how many peeps are there. Either way, anything can happen. It's going to be a friggin' party in the park. I'm excited. Kind of excited, kind of dreading it, but lol, I need to get it done by Friday morning. As soon as it's done Friday morning, I'm just going to friggin' load it. I don't give a damn. Upload it Friday morning, then rest in between lectures, and then going out Friday night, friggin' celebrating student style, what a lad. So yeah, I'm gonna get going, and I think I'm gonna talk to you later. Sorry about the shortness of this video, it's very work at the moment, as you could probably tell. Putting a lot of effort into stuff and things. So, it's very tiring. I'll catch you later. Blub! Actually, I'm not going, and now I just got cramp in my foot, holy cow. Oh wow, that's really inconvenient. Well, I've got an update for you. I wasn't really going to update you, but I've got an update for you. When I was going to go to bed and watch some Sherlock in bed, I was talking to Swimmer Jess, and she was saying she'd never seen Sherlock before, and like she couldn't stay up because her accommodation is like really, like literally above the nightclub She's really inconsiderate. So I said, well, how can you never watch Sherlock? It's friggin'...
Yeah, okay, the poster's there.
Oh my god, your battery's still there, I apologise. Yeah, sure, the poster's a bit on the floor because it won't stick up and I can't bother to make it stick. But it's friggin' amazing. What are you talking about? How have you never watched it before in your entire life? Friggin' watch it now. So we had a film night here watching Sherlock and she's like, she's terrible. She's like, oh, this, God, what is this? People are dying. It's a bit like Scooby-Doo, isn't it? What are you on about? Sherlock Holmes is not like Scooby-Doo. No. Unimpressed. But she seemed to get like into it towards the end and like the cliffhangers. It was the very last episode of the first series and did like the cliffhanger. She's like, what? And then, oh yes. Yes, man. I've sold someone. She's going to borrow my DVD. So, yeah, boy. And then, so I walked her back because it was late and it was about half one. No, not half one. It's half one now. About 12, half 12, something. And I walked back and then I noticed something and I remembered it this morning as well because I thought about it this morning, but I was still half asleep and like didn't really register. I was walking out of the accommodation block with Beth and we walked down the stairs and then walked backwards that way. And then I saw on the floor, Beth didn't see it, like a bit of, like a little like chain, like a bit of bike lock. Like a bike lock was just on the floor. And I walked past it and I thought, that looks like my bike lock. But then I told myself not to worry about it because it was like, well, there's no point, I've got to go to lecture now. There's no point worrying about it if it was my bike lock. Well, one, my bike lock's nice, safely locked up. If it was my bike lock, then you'd probably guess where this is going. If it was my bike lock, then there's no chance of getting that bike back. Well, I just went back and then as I'm walking back into the block now, I look at the bike, I remembered seeing it, and I was like, yeah, look to the bike lock, there's only one bike there. There's usually five. There's usually five bikes. There's one. Mine isn't there. And here is the lock. Huh. There was two chains on it, wrapping around the wheels and things, and a padlock. Look at that shiz was. Just sheared straight off with a bolt cutter or something. So that's exciting, isn't it? So I rung up Ben, who was the bed. Beth and Ben were just going to bed. I was like, do you want to go on an adventure? Do you want to go on an adventure with me? So we went around campus with Beth and Ben, looking for the mysterious bike that's gone missing. Couldn't really particularly... Didn't find it anyway. I don't know why I was expecting to find it. I don't know. I thought it was like more of a prank, like it's been moved to like a bike lock that's just near it. But we went around the whole campus, had a brief look, but obviously it's dark. I might have another look tomorrow in a gap in lectures and stuff. But yeah, it's disappeared. So I warned security. Obviously reported it to security, then warned them that maybe they should keep an eye out to make sure it doesn't happen again. To someone else's bike. And yeah, bit of a weird ending to a weird day. At least I got something to call this video. Hey, something. Something, because otherwise I would have been struggling to think of a top title for this video before this. So, silver linings, it's insured, so. Oh well. I'm gonna get going. I'm actually going to get going now because I need to go to bed. I need to catch up with sleep. I've got to get up at 9 o'clock, so that's about 7 hours sleep for me at the moment. No, I've got to get up before 9 o'clock, so 6 hours sleep. I'm a liar. All night tomorrow. We're going to decimate this, and I'm going to catch you later.